far down within the dim west, where the good and the bad and the worst and the best have gone to their eternal rest. Their shrines and palaces and towers, time-eaten towers that tremble not, resemble nothing that is ours, around by lifting winds forgot, residedly beneath the sky, the melancholy waters lie. No rays from the holy heaven come down on the long nighttime of that town, but the light from out the lurid sea streams up the turrets silently, up domes, up spires, up kingly halls, up fanes of Babylon-like walls, up shadowy long-forgotten boughs, a sculptured ivy and stone flowers, up many and many a marvellous shrine, whose wreathed fancies intertwine, the vial, the violet, and the vine. Residedly beneath the sky, the melancholy waters lie, so blend the torrents and shadows there, that all seem pendulous in the air, while from a proud tower in the town, death looks gigantically down. Their open fanes and gaping graves yawn level with the luminous waves, but not the riches there that lie in each idle diamond eye, not the gaily jeweled dead taint the waters from their bed, for no ripples curl, alas, along the wilderness of glass. No swellings tell that winds may be upon some far-off happier sea. No heavings hint that winds have been on seas less hideously serene. But lo, a stir's in the air, the wave, there is a moment there. And if the towers are thrust aside, slightly sinking the dull tide, and if their tops had feebly given a void within the filmy heaven, the waves have now a redder glow, the hours are breathing faint and low, and when among no earthly moans, down, down the town shall settle hence. Hell, rising from a thousand thrones, shall do in reverence.
Thank you.